So tell me what happened today, the significance of the approval for the saliva test.
So this approval will allow for the use of a what's referred to as an extraction-free saliva test. Extraction-free means that this particular test does not require one of the upfront processes that's associated with most of the tests that are out today. Particularly NP swab tests, which is referred to as RNA extraction. That helps on a number of levels. One, it helps to reduce the cost a little bit. It helps in supply chain because that can be an issue getting the reagents to do those extractions. And it helps a little bit with the timing. So this particular assay also runs on a platform called the Fluidigm Biomark. And this is a very, very highly scalable system that can run a lot of samples at one time. It can also run what we call a lot of assays at one time. So in addition to the fact that we're currently going to run this with the SARS-CoV-2 assay, we are also looking at the possibility of adding flu viruses to this particular assay as we move into that season so that we would be able to test individuals for a number of different viruses, particularly upper respiratory viruses at one time. As I said, the scalability of this platform will, I think, go a long way to helping to alleviate the testing shortages that have been observed. Our one laboratory can today process about 2,000 samples per day in the current format of the assay, and we're planning on scaling that very soon to about 5,000 samples per day just in our one laboratory. So if you start multiplying that over the number of laboratories that already have the Fluidigm instruments, this could scale up very, very quickly to really help shore up the testing gap that exists. Plus, it's saliva-based, so it is much more comfortable for the individuals to give us the sample than NP swabs.
So with this FDA approval today, how long before people will actually be able to use this test?
So we'll be using it here within our institution very soon, starting next week with the return of students. We are currently discussing with individuals in the governor's office about how we can best apply this platform to help with state testing. So those conversations are going on now. So I don't have a date or a timeline for that, but we're in those discussions right now. In addition to our lab, I know there are several other labs that are looking to bring this assay online very quickly. And since the components are generated by Fluidigm, a company that manufactures these kits, it should be very possible for a significant number of labs to bring the assay online pretty quickly.
The governor called this test a game changer in the battle against COVID. What are your thoughts?
I think basically where the governor was referring to there was the scalability of this test, the fact that it's saliva-based, not NP-based. So in addition to the fact that we can run quite a few samples in a relatively small laboratory compared to what it takes with NP swabs and other assays that require extraction processes, I think far more people are going to be willing to go get a test if they know they don't have to have an NP swab. Everyone knows it's a very uncomfortable procedure. And so if someone even thinks that they might have the symptoms, they might be much more amenable to getting the test done.
How accurate is this test?
The all of the tests that we've done to this point demonstrate that it is at least as accurate as NP swabs. We have done retrospective testing for the EUA, and we came out with basically a perfect match in the 68 samples that were done utilized within that particular test testing. But we've been doing a number of additional tests within the institution under IRB, and we've been finding it to be quite sensitive and easily, let's put it this way, it's as sensitive as NP to be determined if there may be cases that it can detect that NP swabs may not be able to.
So the application for this would be for schools, colleges, institutions where you have a lot of people on campus. This could really cut down on the COVID cases, correct?
It certainly could. And again, because of the ease of the collection, I think that's certainly a possibility as we move forward, that this could be utilized in all the formats that you just described very effectively.
Could it be something that is a daily test?
That would certainly, I mean, depending, you know, the numbers you're talking about, obviously it would require a number of labs to scale up for that to happen. But it's not out of the realm of possibility. I know that the company that we work with, Fluidigm, as I mentioned, has been working to be able to provide reagents for this, basically the consumables you use to run the test, at a scale of eventually millions of tests per day. So combined with the other tests that are out there, I think you could eventually get to that point if needed.
So long-term, what you're thinking maybe over the next month or two, how in our day-to-day lives, how common will this test be?
I think it depends on where you are as to how common it might be. I think if you're at a, as you mentioned, an academic institution that has in-person classes, this could be part of your daily or at least weekly life. For the next few months, at least, I would think. If you are in a situation where you're only going to be tested if you're symptomatic, then, you know, in that case, I think it's still helpful. It still enables that. But I think, you know, in terms of the places, whether it be businesses, academic institutions, et cetera, that move to frequent testing, that will be sort of an institution by institution decision.
Anything else that you want to add that we didn't touch on?
No, I think that covered quite a bit of the, you know, I think the key points of the assay and the, you know, basically how this is going to benefit as we move forward.
And I think want to know how, you know, you're saying you're still working with the governor on a time frame of getting this out, but I mean, are we talking, you're saying WashU in the next week, but what about, could we say in the next month?
I believe that's the target, yes.
Okay.
I think we're talking weeks here, not months, as being the target, and possibly not only for our laboratory within the state of Missouri. Again, I don't know, I don't have all the details of other discussions, but I know one of the interests in this test is the fact that it is quite scalable. So it's certainly conceivable to be working to help the state at some level within a period of weeks, potentially a month, and certainly there are other labs that could be bringing this on in that time frame as well.